criticized for to see the empty tomb. John is believed to have been the only disciple to die an old man. John wrote his gospel about A.D. 85 or A.D. 90, after Jerusalem had been destroyed in A.D. 70. History tells us that John was exiled to the Isle of Patmos as an old man. But he was released after 18 months.
Yes, sir.
It is believed that he was released because what he wrote, which is now in the book of Revelation. It believes that the Romans thought that John had lost his mind because of what he wrote. And they wanted the churches to see that they had defeated this old preacher. My sisters and brothers, I have been looking at these four words that was on the back of our Sunday school commentary for some time ago. Now, they are worship, know, trust, worship, and follow. Jesus is the one our Bible, our Sunday school lesson, our worship service are pointing to. Our scripture comes from the John 14:6, where Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." The gospel of John is different from the other gospels. Matthew, Mark, and Luke are called the synoptic gospel.
Amen.
They are alike or similar.
Amen.
They seem to tell the same thing.
Amen.
Matthew began his gospel with the genealogy of Jesus.
That's right, Doc.
From Abraham to Joseph.
Yeah.
Mark began with the word of Isaiah talking about John the Baptist. Luke began by addressing his friend Theophilus and moved on to the angel promising the birth of John to Zechariah.
Amen.
But John began his gospel by letting us know who Jesus is.
That's right, Doc.
He began by saying, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God." Now, the first one is know. We must know Jesus.
Amen, Doc.
John said he was the Word who existed with God in the beginning. And the Word was God. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing made that was made. You find that in the John 1st chapter, verses 1, 2, and 3. In the creation, God spoke, and it came into being. John said that Jesus was the Word. John said that the Word became flesh and lived among us. Jesus became a human being, but he never ceased to be in God, the creator and sustainer of all things and the source of eternal life. Jesus is God's son. You've heard people often say that Jesus is God, and they're right. Jesus is God, but not God the Father. We need to know him.
Amen.
Now, how do we know him? By studying our Bible. Number two is trust. The plan of salvation is believe and receive. And we must trust him in all things. If we receive him, we must trust him. Then we will be reborn. Reborn of the Spirit. And then and only then will you be a child of God. Listen, many people say that they are a child of God. They say that God made us all, so we are all his children. But if you have not been born again, well, but born of the that. Holy Spirit,
amen.
You are not one of God's children.
Amen.
Listen, there are some church folks, and there's a difference between church folks and Christians,
amen.
Who say that they love the Lord.
Uh-huh.
They say they trust the Lord.
Uh-huh.
But they will put more trust in man.
Uh-huh.
What man say or tell them to do, then they do the Lord.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
And I'm talking about their good luck charms.
Well, okay? Yeah.
Who do if you will?
Uh-huh.
We wear them, keep them in our pockets,
uh-huh.
our pocketbooks, uh-huh. our shoes,
yeah.
even in our home.
Well,
man tell you that they will keep you from getting sick. Keep people from doing things to you.
Yeah.
And it tell you how to keep your man or your woman
yeah.
against somebody else's.
All right, dog.
You can hear me.
My question is then, if they work so good, then why are you sick?
Yeah.
Like everybody else, you have high blood,
yeah.
arthritis, pain in your knees and back,
yeah.
but you still keep trusting what man said.
Yeah.
Listen, you have trouble in your home with your children,
yeah.
with your neighbors.
Yeah.
You see that they do not work, but you keep on trusting them.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
What about when it comes to your tithes?
Amen.
I believe why some of us do not tithe is we do not trust God to keep His word.
That's right, Doc.
If we make $10, now it's all right to give a dollar.
Yeah.
But what if we make $1,000?
Amen.
$100 is just too much.
Yeah.
What if we trust God and believe that He would do just what He said?
Yeah.
Then we would not worry about it.
Yeah, right.
All of us can.
Amen.
Malachi 3:10.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They would tell you that God promised us
what?
That He would open up the windows of heaven
yeah.
and pour out blessing that you will not have room enough to receive.
Yeah, right.
But we do not trust God
uh-huh.
to keep His word.
Yeah.
Our wants and our needs come before God.
Uh-huh.
But if you really knew Him,
uh-huh.
then you know that God will take care of His children.
Yeah. Yeah.
My sisters and brothers, number three is worship.
Uh-huh.
Worship is why we come to this building called the church.
That's right, uh-huh. God.
Where Jesus is to be praised and worshiped.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
It is really where the church comes together.
Yes.
God's children are the church.
Yeah.
Where God is the center of all that is going on, or should I say should be.
Yeah. Well.
When we worship, we sing, we pray, we teach, we praise, and we preach God's word.
Yeah.
But every song that is sung in the churches of not praising God.
Well,
some teachers and preachers do not glorify God.
Yeah.
Man.
False teachers and false preachers glorify themselves.
That's right.
Yeah.
And some of us come to the church to serve, but we serve God by serving our fellow man.
Well,
true worship comes from the heart.
Yeah.
And God is the center of our worship.
Yeah. Amen.
Everything we do is to glorify God and to help the church to grow.
Yeah.
In the Ten Commandments that God gave to Israel, I believe this is the only thing that God Himself wrote.
Mm-hmm.
And they are to be obeyed forever.
Yes.
The third commandment says in Exodus 27, you shall not misuse the name of the Lord.
Yeah.
King James said, take his name in vain.
Yeah.
Now, church, we see this and we do this often in our churches.
Yeah.
How? In our hypocritical worship.
Well, yes.
In our phony shouts.
Uh-huh.
Our meaningless prayers.
Amen.
Show off songs.
Amen.
And doing things to impress someone else.
That's right.
Yeah. Say that.
And sister brother number four is follow.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. If you know him, if you trust him, if you worship him, then why not follow him?
That's right, Doc.
Yes,
Jesus, the Son of God, came into the sin-sick world.
Yeah.
To show us what God, our Father, was like.
Yeah,
teach
how
we should live to please our Father.
Yeah, that's right.
And how to live at peace with our fellow man.
Yeah.
My sisters and brothers, think about this if you will. Before Jesus came into this world,
Well.
God would speak to holy men to tell his people what he wanted them to know.
Jesus.
But man could only speak what God had told him to say.
Yeah.
They tell me that God needed someone to go down and do what he needed to be done.
Yes.
But no one could be found in heaven, on earth, or beneath the earth.
Yeah.
They tell me that Jesus came forward and said, make me a body.
Amen.
And I will go down and redeem
amen.
From the sin.
Yeah.
In the fullness of time.
Uh-huh.
God gave his only son.
Yeah. Well.
He was born in a stable in Bethlehem of Judea.
Yeah.
At the age of 12, he is seen in the temple in Jerusalem talking with the elders and the teachers of the law.
Yes.
About the age of 30, he was baptized by John the Baptist down in the river of Jordan.
Yes.
As he was coming out of the water,
yes.
The Spirit of God came down from heaven and sit upon him.
Yes.
And the voice from heaven said, this is my beloved son,
yes.
Whom I am well pleased.
Yes.
Then he was led by the Spirit out into the wilderness,
yeah.
Be tempted by the devil.
Yeah.
Before Jesus came into the world, the devil only had man to deal with.
Yeah.
He knew that man had to die, go into some grave, and never return.
Yeah.
But now he has to deal with Jesus, God's son.
Yeah.
And he knows that he was no match for God's son.
Yeah.
The devil waited until Jesus finished his 40 days of fasting.
Yeah.
No doubt Jesus hungry and tired.
Yeah.
But the devil was still no match for Jesus.
Yeah.
He tried to get Jesus to make a deal with him.
Yeah.
But that didn't work.
Yeah.
My sisters and brothers, after Jesus had defeated the devil,
yeah.
As he was returning from the wilderness,
yeah.
He passed by where John was baptized.
Yeah.
John said, behold the Lamb of God who will take away the sins of the world.
Yeah.
For the next 3.5 years, Jesus did the work that his Father wanted him to do.
Go
so that sinful man may be able to be redeemed from his sins.
Yeah.
Jesus did many things to prove that he was the Messiah that was to come.
Yeah.
And everything that he did, every message, every miracle,
every
lesson that he taught,
took
him closer to that day that he would be the Lamb of God that would take away the sins of the world.
Yeah.
And Jesus was about to go to the cross.
Uh-huh.
And he worked for his Father was almost coming to an end.
Yeah.
He told his disciples to love one another.
Yeah.
And Jesus was having his last supper with his disciples.
Yeah.
I believe he looked at them and saw some sad faces.
Yeah.
Then he said, let not your heart be troubled.
Yeah.
Believe in God, believe also in me.
Yeah.
He promised them he was going back to his Father's house.
Uh-huh.
He made things ready for them and us.
Yeah.
And that he would return and take them for he was.
All right.